Alrighty guys, how's she going today? So this must be a quick video. I got you guys on a little tripod. Just I've been leaving that on lately. It's easier to hold the camera. Just get my gloves on. So I'll just try to pick you guys up here now. So of course it's Black Friday today. Of course everything's on freaking on sale, like, you know, like it's gonna end. Kind of thing. It's crazy. Well, it is going to end tonight, obviously, but it's actually pretty nice out. It's not too bad. It's supposed to get 20 above, and then from there, it's supposed to just keep going up. I think even one day, they're talking almost 30 again. But they got a they got a storm coming our way. A snowstorm. Apparently. Whatever. So, I just got done having dinner too. So, I was gonna have you guys take a look at this light here. I just wanna now this is from Ultra Toll or whatever. Same company as where I got my other little battery operated LED light thing for Big Red, right? So, but I wanted to get your guys' opinion on it. I think I've done my homework on it. And apparently, it's 12 volt. The amperage is, let's see, it's looks like one amp, whatever. So, but this is like a floodlight. And LED. It's more like a light bar kind of thing, but it's not round. It's, well, you'll see here in a minute. I'm not even going to try to explain it, but you'll see it anyway. But I was thinking, because they have it on sale, but it's not going to last, obviously, because Black Friday will be ending tonight. Probably at midnight, I guess. I don't really know, but I was kind of thinking maybe doing two of those on Big Red and then maybe one on the John Deere, but I'm thinking I only need to do one, apparently, for both, because these lights apparently, well, I'll sit on their website, but it don't show here, but the light, apparently, since it's a floodlight, it actually shoots 30 feet. I guess if you angle it right, then it'll go 30 feet, but for Big Red, it'll probably, well, the way I plan on putting it, it should be alright. I think since it's a wide light, it's not a round light. See, I think the thing with the round ones, they don't really, you know, blah all over the place. They just kind of light up a little spot, you know. And by the way, I do have my heater running. Full blast. And it's been going for about 15 minutes, and it's actually not too bad in here. It's still cold, but I'm going to actually let that heater run. Mostly for today, I'm gonna see what it would really do. Now, I do mind you that it's not that cold out either. It's only like 20 above. It's still cold, but it ain't freezing cold. So, I think the heater would do all right. As long as it heats up my workbench area, I think I'm all right with it. I don't really need to heat the whole thing anyway, unless I'm working on something in here. But in the wintertime, it ain't gonna happen. But I was live chatting with a lady on Northern Tool about it. I had asked her what comes with it besides the light and the mount. Like, does it come with any wiring or any kind of thing like that? And from what she told me, it comes with wiring, but it's like a permanent kind of thing where it comes on with the key of your tractor or your four-wheeler or your car or whatever. There's no on-off switch for it. But she says they're hauling crap with their freaking son of a bitch place again. They're just, I don't know what the hell they're dumping. Looks like sand or something. Maybe it's gravel for next year, I don't know. But she said that you can order a wiring kit for $20. That allows you to have an on-off switch, which is what I need, because I don't want these coming on only in the nighttime. There's no point in sending power to them during the day when you don't need them, right? So but I'm just trying to figure it out how this gets wired, because I think there's more to it than just a positive negative. I think there's also a ground, which you think that would be the negative, but maybe not. I think that's a totally different setup. But for the grounding, well, you just bolt that to your frame of your tractor or something, you know. That's not a big fucking deal. I can do that easy. But I just hope that the wiring is right, because on Big Red, I have to put the switch somewhere on either like the handlebar kind of thing or on Big Red's like dash. Like there's those two little, I don't know what the hell you call them. I just call them humps, you know, they kind of go up. I'm thinking maybe I'll just knock one of them out, drill it out, and then put the switch on that. And then there you go. And she said that also you can run two lights on one, you know, like one set of wiring for an on-off switch. It's just, you know, just simply two lights on one wire. So I don't know how that would, I don't know how that works. I think you probably just, not sure how that works. Either you just team together, or if you, you know, like you cut the wire in half and then you tie the wire onto that wire and then you just put electrical tape over it. I don't know. Or maybe you, I don't know. I haven't gotten that far really. So, but I don't know. I'm thinking maybe one, well, I want to do two lights on Big Red, but I kind of wonder if maybe one wouldn't be enough for now. Until I figure out what the wiring is kind of like. And apparently she couldn't find, I had asked her if they sold the wiring kit, like the on-off switch for it. And she said that she couldn't find anything on her end of the deal. And then I went to the light and I just scrolled down some more. I was like, well, there's a wiring kit right there for it. Like, I totally gave her, you know, like, the name of the light and everything. I gave her all the information on that, you know, and I told her what it was and stuff, and she couldn't find a damn thing. I was like, yeah, I just found it, so. And it had an on-off switch and everything. And it also has a built-in fuse, too, so that'd be fine. That's something I like that, so it's a little safer for the light, so they don't blow up. The light is waterproof. I think the wiring is, too. So, I guess, if you wanted it, like, the permanent kind of way, which is, you know, like an auto light, which is what cars have nowadays, the lights just turn on with the key. She said that's what these would do, if you just used the standard wiring connections. She said that you just hook the positive, negative, negative, and then I think the ground, too, I think. You just ground it out, and then, and that's it. It comes on, then. Which I don't think that would really be really a good thing, because I think the lights would be on constantly. I don't know, because I don't know, because when you, if you leave the lights on, the four-wheeler on, and then you shut them off, the lights turn off, no matter if the switch is on or not. So it just kills all the power. The John Deere, it's not that well. It is, but then in a way, it ain't kind of thing. If you turn the key on, but you don't start it, it'll shut everything down, but I guess
it leaves the lights running if you leave them on, so you can drain your battery easy that way. But I don't think I'm gonna. I haven't done that yet, so I'm not gonna worry about it. But it doesn't seem like it's really that hard because, you know, positive to positive, negative to negative, and then I think there's a ground. Well, you just bolt that to their, you know, to something metal, which I'd probably just go right to the frame or something, or a bolt. And there you go. So, and I guess the light is is waterproof, and it also can angle up and down. And of course, you can do it left and right, but you have to mess with the main bolt to get it to turn left or right. But you can go up and down, you know, no problem. Well, it's bolted too. We just loosen it up with, you know, a couple of those or something, right? A couple of wrenches, and then there you go. So, I don't know. Like I said, I'm still trying to figure it out, but I think I got it pretty much. I don't really want a big light, you know. I know Mossman gave me a few ideas and stuff, you know, and he told me to get, you know, these kind of lights and stuff and blah, 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 you know. And yeah, I could, but I don't really want round lights because they're just so old school looking, you know. And they might get in the way. I might have a lot of tree branches and stuff, and they might just get in the way. So, with this light, it's a little more flatter. And yeah. And these light bulbs, apparently they're supposed to last up to 50,000 hours. I'll put the link below, you guys can check it out. So, and I guess they also have a... whatever this is, let's see here. Handlebar light mount. So I guess you can, I'll show you that too, but I guess you can mount the lights to that if you had like, I guess maybe like, well, like a handlebar, which I don't know why you would want to mount it to your, well, for ATVs you wouldn't do that, but if you had like a rack that was round, which is what I plan on getting for the front of Big Red, or for the back of Big Red. So, well, no, I can't do it on the back. I would have to, I don't know. I'll do it on the front for sure, but the back, I really can't have a rack, I guess. So, well, I could, but, you know, it'd just be in the way. So, that's why I figured I would just, because see, on the back rack of the four-wheeler, I got one hole already there, but that's for the flag, which I'm never going to put a flag on them. So, there's a free hole right there I could use. And then on the other one, we just drill. We just drill a hole right through it. Well, I got a DeWalt, you know, a drill and some bits. Which could probably go through that real easy. But, I don't know, I'm thinking 30 feet is quite a long way to go. Jeez. But see, the thing is, I don't know how wide they shoot. Apparently they shoot pretty far, or pretty wide. I mean, it's got 5 LED lights in it, and stuff, you know, so it should shoot pretty far. But if I'm not happy with one, apparently I could tee in another one. Not sure how that would work, but maybe it would work, I don't know. Well, there's probably some special way of doing it, I don't know, but... give her. But yeah, I'll show you the light here. Let me know what you boys think. If you guys think, let's just camera focus. It's letter C. Letter C there. That oval looking kind of one. This one right there. Whoop. Right there. That's the one. And then if you go down here, and you find letter C, which you're probably guys are not going to be able to find that. But if you find letter C there, then there's all the information. There's even more. Right there, and on their website. That's for all these lights. See, it was something like this that Mossman wanted me to get. Something like that. Something round, roundish. I don't like that. I'm not crazy for round shapes. You know, I kind of want something unique. You know, and this one's kind of fancy looking and stuff. Yeah, there's that. Handlebar mounting kind of dewy thingy. But see, the reason why I like these lights is because look how they're—you just bolt them. So you just drill a hole, and then there you go. And of course, then I would run the wiring underneath the freaking what you call it, you know, the rack. So, you know, I guess it wouldn't be, and you just run it along the frame, and you run it up to the front, run it up to the battery there. But I guess I'm kind of running out of room on the battery too. I might have to swap those bolts, because it still has the factory bolts in the battery. I might have to get slightly longer ones. I don't know, but I'm kind of running out of room because the way they wired everything, it was kind of a nuisance. Because when I put the tender on, it was a nuisance to get that on, get that wiring on. And yes, this does have ring terminals for the battery, you know, just like what the tender had. So it's like a permanent wire connection thing. So, yeah. Apparently they do have switches for these, like a wiring kit that has a switch built into them, which is what I need, because I don't want them just coming on with the turn of the key, you know, because there's no point in, you know, putting hours on them, and it's in the middle of the freaking daytime. It's stupid. They're only there for nighttime use, you know. Yeah, sure, you can have them on in the daytime for, you know, like, safety reasons, but in other words, frick that. I don't need them on, so I'm still going to get a safety light. Let's see if I can. I'm kind of wearing gloves here, so it's really hard to. So they got more lights here too, but I'm not crazy for that. What is? Yeah, I still gotta get one of these. One of these kind of lights for Big Red. I think I'm gonna go with that one. $30. They got a cheaper one. Oh, they had a cheaper one here, right here. But I don't know. I kind of like this one better. It's kind of smaller, more flashier. I wanted to get this light bar, but I'm not paying. What is it? Letter A. Yeah, I'm not paying $150 for that. Probably even more than that. That's actually just a discount price. I would hate to know what the real price of that is. Scary. But I don't know. I think maybe. I know one on the back of the John Deere probably would be fine. Big Red, that's kind of a different story because, not really, I guess, because I'm pulling the same size cultivator, you know, either way. So, but if I don't find that one's enough, then you just put on another one. What's so freaking hard about it? I really don't see what's so hard about it. That's how you learn your wiring skills. You just freaking give her. And I wired up the battery tenders. The battery junior tender kind of things. I did that all myself. Took me a while, but not too bad. You know, it's just positive to positive and negative to negative and route your wiring. So it can't be too hard with lights. It's just I think with lights, they have a ground wire too. Which I think you just, like I said, you just find something metal, like the frame or something, and there you go. So I'm sure I could do something. And if I don't have anything, like a bolt close enough to ground my wire, I think what you could do is just find a piece of metal wire. I'd have to probably buy it. Well, there's some up there, but just run that up to, you know, to the closest bolt. And then you can just ground it through the wire, through the, you know, the steel wire, and there you go. Then it's grounded. So, but that's, you know, in extreme cases that, you know, or something, if I had to do that, I could. But I don't find that necessary. I don't think that's gonna have to happen. But if it does, it does. But no, whatever. So, if you guys could give me some feedback on what you guys think of this light. I don't really think that it'd be too hard. It's gonna really be easy on Big Red because where I'm gonna put this light will be right there in the flagpole. So that way I don't have to, you know, drill anything because it's already pre-drilled for me. And I think that light that's on the back now of Big Red, that little battery operated one thing, I might take that one off. Even though I kind of like it for the glove box kind of thing, but it doesn't really light up the glove box. So, well, I might even put it, I was thinking of maybe putting that light in the glove box at Big Red. But it'd be taking it, I would lose so much room because of the box. So I might just take that off and find a different use for it. So I kind of do need another light over that one shelf where the chainsaw is, but on the bottom, not the bottom, but the second shelf, because there's also a top shelf. Well, I got a little box full of junk, you know, like nails and just, you know, general crap. Put that little light over there because it's hard to see because the closest light that's there doesn't light it up very well. I think that is a 100 watt light bulb too, and doesn't really do anything. Such a big garage too, right? So they're banging the crap out of their trailers or their dump boxes. But yeah, so I don't know. What do you boys think? I don't really think there's nothing wrong with it. Letter C there. So I don't really know what's too bad about it, but the thing is, see, I'm going to have to order the wiring kit for it. So I don't know. I don't really know. Well, probably, obviously. I don't want to keep saying that. Because, yeah, I have to. Because I don't want it to be permanently on. When you flip the key, right? But she said that they come with wiring, but it's supposed to be like a permanent on light kind of thing. It comes on when you turn the key on. So, and I don't want that. If I was putting these on, maybe like something that I planned on running at in the nighttime, and only the nighttime, then I could see that, because it would be annoying to flip the switch all the time. But, you know, in my case, no. I do plan on, you know, plowing snow. Apparently, there's supposed to be that big snowstorm that's supposed to show up in the next day or two. And it snowed a little bit last night, so we got about half an inch, maybe a quarter of an inch of snow on the ground. So, not bad. It ain't, fuck it. It's not worth scraping. It's not worth scraping with the shovel either, so piss it. I guess if I had a rotary broom on the tractor, I could just sweep it, but, you know, in other words, frick it. So, I'll put the link below to the light, and I'll also put the link to the wiring kit, I guess, that's supposed to go with that. It's a 12-volt wiring kit, and these lights are good from 9 volts all the way up to 32 volts, or, you know, 32 volts. So, I guess anywhere in between it'll run. I guess it just depends on battery and wiring and whatever else, right? You know, I just can well imagine what this big light bar would be like. Let's see if it'll focus. Look at that big sucker. Letter B. I think that's letter B. Let's see here. Yeah, letter B. Big, huge sound bitch. Oh, that would freaking be bright as hell. Damn. Oh, we don't need that. That's just way too extreme. So, if you guys would leave me some feedback on that, let me know what you think. Like I said, I'll put the links below. And I don't really plan on uploading any more videos because I don't really have any videos. I'm waiting for snow to come so I can plow, make a plowing video, and I want to make a new intro, but I kind of need snow. So, so in a way, I'm looking for snow, but in a way, I don't want it, you know. I mean, just give me this little bit of snow, and then never come again. So at least I can make my new intro, and then there we go. This is only going to be for the wintertime. It's not going to be for the summertime. So, it's going to be a wintertime intro. So, I don't know what you guys think of the light. I think it's alright. I mean, it seems pretty simple for wiring. You know, I don't think it's going to be a nightmare. You know, now if I were to wire, you know, a snow plow to a truck, totally different ball game. You got so much wiring here, I wouldn't even know what to do with it all. But see, but here, it's just, you know, a little strand of wire, and that's it. It's not really that bad, so. I don't know. It's LED, so it's supposed to be bright. But if it performs to the way that I'm thinking it would, I probably only need one. And the same for the John Deere, because the John Deere definitely needs one on the back. That's just nuts. One should definitely be enough. I'll probably put it maybe mostly directly right behind the seat, so that way it'll broadcast just right. Because if you put it kind of off to the side, then it shows too much light on one side, and then it's stupid. So even though you could adjust it, but I don't know. It's all just going to have to be eyeballed and shit, you know. But if you guys want to leave your feedback on that, let me know what you think. If you think it's worth it, I think so, but, you know, I don't really know. I got this little light here from them. Come on. I only gotta go one page over. See, this is what I bought for Big Red last year. It was this little strip light right here. It's a battery light, you know, typical thing. For $30. That's what's on the back of Big Red right now. It doesn't really perform to what I thought it would, but, you know, I should have expected that, but it does okay. I mean, it's a good little backup light if you happen to be in the nighttime and you're trying to find, like, a screwdriver or something in your glove box and you need some kind of a light, and then you just flip the light and then find a tool and then bring it down to the light and see what you got, right? So, it's a good little, you know, simple light for that kind of deal, but if you wanted to use it for cultivating at night or snow blowing or, you know, whatever your use would be for, that light there wouldn't really be the best. So I think it's about time we upgraded to at least, you know, this one here. They got, you know, little bigger ones too, but I don't think I need that one. Plus this one's only going for, let's see. Well, right now it's going, well, on this here, it's going for $60, but since it's, you know, I'm not going to get it today, obviously, but since it's Black Friday, it's on sale for $5 less. And the shipping's probably still, you know, overkill, but whatever. At least you get it here quick. So I'm not going to complain about their shipping, because I'm willing to pay for it, so it's not a big deal. Harbor Freight is a joke. Even though I like them, their shipping's bullshit. But they do sell good stuff. This is where I bought my, holes are stiff, but that's where these quick couplers come from, was Harbor Freight. And I like them. They're not bad, so the ones from Northern 2 would be good too, but, you know, I want to give, you know, Harbor Freight some credit, you know, for, you know, I just don't want to get everything from Northern 2. So, but, you know, if I have to order something and I don't need it right away, Harbor Freight is the way to go. But if you need something kind of like right away, then Northern Tools is the way to go. Or you just go directly to who's ever selling it and get it there. So, and another thing I was going to show you guys too, but I think I'll just tell you. Because I don't really want to take a ton of your guys' time. But I've been looking at air compressors, as you guys have known. You know, because this thing's getting wore out. Well, they're selling a 30-gallon air compressor, 110, 115 volt, but 15 amps. It's a 30-gallon air compressor. And I was like, whoa, mama. I want it, but I would need a 15-amp wire ran back here from the house, or at least a 20, which I planned on doing in the summertime. I'm just going to do it. Frick it. And then, and, yeah, so it was a 30-gallon air compressor. It's got the same setup as mine. You know, it takes the same size hose and you know, and crap like that. But this one apparently is a 20-gallon. I kind of wonder if it's not. Well, it probably is. It just doesn't seem like it's a 20-gallon. It looks more like a 10 or a 15, but I'm sure someone will correct me on that, which is fine. That's what I want. I want to be corrected, so. But yeah, it probably is a 20 gallon. It probably would say on the sticker, but the sticker's kind of dickered. So, yeah, it doesn't really matter. But I can't afford it anyway. I think it was going for like 800 bucks. Well worth the money, but, you know, frick. Maybe a future deal. Maybe when the shop gets wired correctly for it, then we'll do it that way. But for now, I might just end up buying me another 20 gallon. I was going to at one time. Well, I still am. It's going to be a vertical. This one's a horizontal, I guess. Which means the tank lays down. The vertical, I think it was, stands up. So I guess that's what I want, but see, now I would have to move the air compressor over. I might even just put it over there, because now I got my hose reel in the way of it, so. We'll make it work. Don't worry about it. We'll make it work. If I gotta put the shelf up some more, I can do that, too. It's not a big deal, even though it is screwed really well to the studs. But whatever. I gotta replace those screws, too. They're getting... I guess the DeWalt is just has too much power for them little things. Just stripped them right out. A couple of them are stripped right out, but I might have been using the wrong bit. So, freaking snow. But yeah, so, I don't know what you guys think of that light. I want your guys', you know, feedback on it. Because I don't want to buy something and it's junk. But I think it's good. I don't think there's really anything wrong with it. You know. So. If I did order it today, just saying, if I did, I really don't know if I would wire it up in the wintertime. I probably could, but it's just getting so cold. Well, I was supposed to get in the 30s, but by the time it got here, it would be cold again, so. But I don't know. It just depends on what day it is and how cold it is. I might just wait to spring and order it, but, you know. At least it gives me time to figure it out if it's worth it, and you guys can leave your feedback, and, you know, I guess it just takes time. So, I guess just let me know what you guys think. If you think it's worth money or not. I'll show you one more time here, but I think you boys know what it is by now. So, like I said, there'll be the link below. So, you guys can take a look at it. I'll put the link to the wiring kit, too, and you boys can tell me if that's the right one. I think it is, because it's a 12-volt light, and the wiring is 12-volt, too. So, I think it'll be all right. But I think I'm going to be leaving here pretty quick, so I'm going to slowly turn my heater down, let it cool down a little bit. So I don't really know when I'm going to... Let's just wait till the banging stops. Maybe you can't even hear it, but I sure know I can, but... Yeah, so... I'm hoping to get this trailer project underway in spring. You know, this stupid thing. Hopefully we can get her done. I still want to order that sandblaster Dewey. Little 10 ounce. I think this air compressor probably could run the 50 gallon thing, but I'd probably drain the air on it so fast that the air compressor would be running all day. It'd probably take me an hour to blow even just that front hitch off. So with that little guy, I think it'd be a little easier on it. It would be more time consuming, but whatever. But I'm gonna probably start getting some paint, some spray paint, and primer for this trailer. I'm gonna stock up on that, and then when the time comes, we'll have all the parts, and then we can start sandblasting and painting. I could get a wire wheel for the grinder or the drill and grind it all off, but I just think that's not going to work, because some of this paint's on there really good, and the only way you're going to get it off is with a sandblaster, so. But definitely the rims. The rims are definitely shit. They definitely need to be hit with a sandblaster. Not sure how I'm going to do that with the rubber on. I don't know if I could just put duct tape around the rubber a little bit and then just, you know, to help protect it. Or if maybe the rubber would be alright, I don't know, but you guys can tell me. So, but yeah, so I'm going to stop talking now, cut you guys off, and start uploading this video for today. There's not going to be an intro or anything, but it just takes too long then, but I don't know what you guys think of that light. I think it would be worth it, but I don't know. You would think one would be enough. I mean, if it shoots 30 feet, it's probably got a wide shot on it too. You know, I mean, one might be enough. If not, then you always add on another one. But I think for now, I'll just probably do one, and then I'll do the John Deere in the spring because I'm not gonna run the John Deere now. So, but yeah. So, anyways. You may not see any videos for maybe a couple days. I don't really know. It's just, you know, there's not a lot going on. I'm waiting to see what this snowstorm's going to do. If it's going to produce anything for us or not. In a way, I want it because I want to plow and I want to make my new intro. But then in a way, I don't want it. So, I kind of have to choose. Well, it's only as long as we don't get anywhere after that. Then I guess I'm alright, but, you know. I'm already looking forward to spring. We're not, you know, it's just the beginning of winter and I'm already sick of it. I want spring. Give me summer. What the hell is this hanging here? Oh, it's just a piece of wire. So, yeah, so anyways, guys, let me know what you think of the wire. I'm going to take off. Start uploading this. And, you guys can just leave me your feedback. If I don't understand something about the wiring, I could always either make a video on it for you guys, or I can always talk to Northern Tool. They would be more than glad to help. That truck's got a damn vibrator on it. I didn't know dump trucks had vibrators. I think only some do. It's a pretty damn good feature, I would say. But anyway, I'm just running out of words to say over here. So I guess I'm just going to take off. Let me know what you guys think of this light. I'm going to take off and start uploading. So if you don't see a video from me in a couple of days, this is why, because I ran out of things to talk about. But hopefully maybe we'll get some snow plowing vids going up here pretty soon if we get anything worth freaking plowing. And if it's just a little bit, I might just be taking a shovel to it. But whatever. Yeah, so anyways, I'm going to take off, so I guess have a good day and stuff. So yeah. Thanks for watching, guys. See you guys later.